In the year 424 BC, the Peloponnesian War between Sparta and Athens was at a climax. Strategically, Athens had to secure their northern front if they were to have any chance of winning this war. They invaded the Greek lands of the Boeotian League, who was a client state of Sparta during this period. The Athenians, led by the general Hippocrates, marched on the Boeotian city of Delium. Delium was a significant coastal city which would allow the Athenians a base of operation on land and by sea throughout Boeotian territory. As the Athenians arrived at Delium, the Boeotians, under the command of the Theban general Pagondas, had gathered an army of 18,000 soldiers. 7,000 were heavy Theban and Thessalian hoplites. The additional 10,000 were lighter hoplites and lighter infantry, with the remainder 1,000 being Theban and Thessalian cavalry and skirmisher units. They marched on Delium, meeting the Athenians on the field of battle. Pagondas leads his Boeotian force toward the Athenians, his force gaining the advantage immediately as they took the high ground atop a hill overlooking the plains. Pagondas had stationed a much deeper rank formation on his right flank, looking to overwhelm the Athenians on their left. The Athenians, in contrast, spread out their battle line evenly, giving them a longer battle line compared to the Boeotians. Hippocrates commanded a force of roughly 15,000 soldiers, 7,000 of which were heavy Athenian hoplites, another 7,000 lighter hoplites, and lighter Greek infantry, with the remainder 1,000 being skirmishers and cavalry. Both Hippocrates and Pagondas stationed their skirmishers and cavalry on either flank to stop one another from attempting to flank their battle lines. As both armies came within range of each other, Hippocrates began addressing his men, during which the Boeotians came charging downhill toward the Athenians.
Our honored ancestors are watching today. We have a proud tradition of courage, honor, and bravery to match, and I know that you will not be found wanting. Hey! Now, the hour approaches.
Charge!
Thank you.
Even though the Athenian army was slightly outnumbered and positioned downhill, putting them at a disadvantage, Hippocrates ordered the Athenians to charge at the oncoming Boeotians. He was confident in his more experienced, hardened soldiers. The downhill momentum of the clash pushed back the Athenian lines, particularly on the Boeotians' right flank, where they had stationed the bulk of their force. As the battle progressed, the Boeotian right flank began to slowly push back the Athenian left flank, although throughout the rest of the battle lines, the superior Athenian soldiers were having more success against their Boeotian hoplite foes. On the flanks, the sloped terrain and Boeotian javelin men repelled the Athenian cavalry from engaging.
Thank you.
Pagondas, worried that his center and left flank would soon collapse, sent his cavalry reserves to their aid, using the sloped terrain and hills to mask their movements. The Theban hoplites on the right flank were successfully pushing back the Athenian left, though at the same time the Boeotian center and left flank had collapsed and were retreating up the hills. Just as it seemed as though the Athenians were to gain victory, Pagondas' large cavalry reserves came riding atop the hill. The Athenians, seeing a large cavalry force riding down the slope, assumed it was a second Boeotian army.
Advance!
The Athenians began to panic. They quickly turned and routed down the hill. Seeing this, the Boeotians turned and began to chase the Athenians. Soon after the rest of the Athenians' army retreated. What was to be a heroic victory for the Athenians soon turned into a defeat due to confusion and lack of leadership, though it was reported that the Athenian general Hippocrates was killed not long into the battle, which would explain why the Athenians were not commanded properly, which played a part in their demise. Historians reported the losses as 1,200 dead Athenian soldiers, including Hippocrates himself. The Boeotians were reported to have lost only 500 or so men, which seems rather unrealistic, considering the collapse of their center and left flank. The real number was probably closer to what the Athenians had lost.